1 Peter chapter 2 verse 9.
Today let's talk about our calling to the light. Peter had experience of understanding that when you are in the dark, you can waste all your years,
days,
struggling to get what is close to you. The light that God has called you to is when people say it's over with you. They'll be surprised you find a direction. God wants people, according to the standard of the world, He wants people, according to the standard of the world, they are nothing. And He called them to His marvelous life. Astonishing. People have to be surprised of you. Ephesians 5, from Ephesians 5, verse 8. Just read that verse there. We'll read from 8 to 13. This is the time that we need to know why we are in the light. You know, the light is there to enlighten us. The light is not there for us to hide the truth. The truth is the truth. Your experience is what you are going through. Your response to those experiences
determine
who you are. If you are a Christian of the light, or you are a heathen in darkness. If you are in the light, anything against you must teach you to do better.
Matthew 14, verse 1 to 12.
You know, many people who are Christians, many people who are in the light will be killed by the people in the dark. You are called to the light. Don't fear death. You are called to the light. You know where you're going. You have to face a great opposition. But God will never allow you to die before you finish your
service.
If we want to stand in lies, we will be finished one day. It is better you stand in truth, even if you can be hated. It's better you show that you're of the light. Do you know that always if you follow people, two things can happen to you? It is possible they can mislead you. It is possible that you can join them. Either they mislead you, you don't join them, or you join them. So many times when you follow people, you forget that there's light of God upon you. And the light of God will go down. Because the light of God is there for revelation.
It's
there to enlighten your eyes to know the truth. Proverbs 13 verse 9. The wicked, they are not complete. They live to prove temporarily. But Christians who have the light, they carry on shining. When the wind blew, the light grows
And it brings happiness to them.
Whatever you are facing,
you searching
for something that God has planted in you. Don't be afraid of any challenge you are going through. Keep that lamp burning. Keep the lamp of God in you burning. And the light of God will show you the direction of God. At the end of the tunnel, there is victory. You may not be seeing what is happening at the present. Keep the lamp of God.
You'll
be able to see the answers at the end. Luke 11, verse 33 to 36,
John 1 verse 7.
If you live in the light, is now you have fellowship with him. If you have fellowship with him, you will have right fellowship with others. To live in the light is to have these three things: the goodness of God, the righteousness of God, the truth must be seen in you, visible from you. Let us not talk about the blood of Jesus before we live in the light. The blood of Jesus Christ is there, that when you are supposed to be touched by sin, it will prevent you. Prevent you and take away the stains of sin.
Then 8 verse 12. John 8:12.
If we follow him, he's in the light, we have fellowship with him, how can we fail if we have his life? Genesis 21, verse 14 to 20.
Let me
see where there's no light. We will surrender what belongs to us. When there's no light, we'll be hopeless when the solution is there. Where there's no light, we will search for things, whereas God has put us where those things are. If we carry on living in darkness, we will miss a lot of opportunities. We will die when solutions are there. We need to know that God here, he doesn't want us to die. He wants us to have our own assignment. The assignment of you are here today, people have discouraged you because of what is happening to you. But this is the time now of taking the light of the living God to be our light. At the moment when we do that, we'll surprise even our parents. We'll surprise even those who rejected us.
John 1 verse 8 and 9.
The light of God in him was there to enhance every man. It just takes us, when we believe in Christ, the light of God, that it becomes our life. Whatever we are going through, we won't be ashamed because we have got the light of God. Whatever we are going through today, the light of God will come upon. What is hidden from your eyes, today God will open your eyes. You'll be able to see it in the name of Jesus. If you believe, shout hallelujah.